Hey everybody, I'm gonna light our virtual candle to get us started. Then I'm gonna turn the recording off. There we go. Ooh, that was cool. All right, and I'm gonna turn the recording off until we get everybody here and gathered. Recording in progress. I'm going to begin that. And again, thank you all so much for coming. It's always my pleasure to hold the Create Alongs, because the folks that seem to be drawn to this are always such special, tender-hearted, kindred, arty, delicious people. So thanks so much for joining me and taking the time out to honor yourself and give yourself some time and space to just create and be. Because one thing that I always say on the Kindreds page is there are enough have-tos in our life that it's really nice to hold space and have some want-to time. Last time that we got together, what I focused on was we started by just holding space and focusing on how's your heart. And this time I was inspired by a friend of mine. We're having a housewarming here, hence my Julia Child background and makeup and earrings, you guys. I have like my hair's done. I don't have my hat on, so this is like a big deal. it looks like a gosh darn YouTube video. But anyway, a dear friend is coming. A lot of dear friends are coming. People who have, I'm looking, Verena, you're in the mountains of Northern California. My goodness, it must be beautiful there too. What I want to focus on for just a minute, we're going to pull focus in, and we're just going to, rather than everyone focusing on how's your heart, we're just going to focus on something that one of my dear friends always talks about, and it's what feels important. So rather than taking a minute and just focusing on how's my heart this morning, we're just going to take 1 minute, and you can close your eyes if you want to, you don't have to, and you're just going to focus on what feels important. So just again, close your eyes, don't close your eyes, take a soft gaze, whatever, but we're just going to focus on what feels important. And again, try not to think. Try to just settle into your heart. Listening to the whistling wind. You might be listening to your dog or your breath. What feels important? All right, that's a rather abrupt timer. A nice bell would have probably been nicer. So the other thing that I do at the beginning is we just go around, and we don't take a lot of time, but we just take a little time. And everyone, if you could just say your name and then just one thing. You can either share what came up for you as important, where you are, what you plan on working on today, or you can just pass and tell us your name if you want to. And I'm just going to go around the little Brady Bunch circle, because that's easier than waiting for, okay, who wants to go next? And then we have this awkward, because that tends to be a thing. It's just human. So I'll just go first. I'm Stacy. And what feels important to me today, I'm going to do that one. Is just community and connection and love. So that's me. And Katie White, you are my first Brady Bunch circle in this corner, or square in this corner. So if you would go next, that'd be lovely.
Okay, I'd be happy to. My name's Katie. And what feels important to me right now is staying in my heart space. I'm doing some chakra work, and as much as I kind of need to work on the root, today the heart is calling. So.
Lovely, thank you. Monica Walk, you are next in my little square.
Yeah, I'm Monica. And I want to say I'm in Fond du Lac, Wisconsin. I'm curious to know where people are. So if anyone feels like sharing that would be fun to know too. And filling my bucket. Self-care. I mean, I know we hear about that a lot, and it kind of sounds a little, you know, I don't know, stereotypical, but that really came up. I do a lot of caring for the people that I love, and I'm being reminded I need to do that. So that's why I'm here.
Dig it.
I'll hop in and say I'm from Evansville, Indiana.
Oh, cool. Thanks. Kara.
Hey. I'm Kara. And I'm in Southern California, so that's, and I just woke up, so hence me wandering around. you know, it's funny, I really liked what Katie said. I was going to say something really shallow, but I really liked Katie right now, because I need to work on my root chakra a lot too, because I was nearly in tears just in the 1 minute. I was like, oh my God. But, you know, on a more shallow level, I'm trying to get a bunch of work done, because I've got the first art market / festival in over 2 years, because life has thrown some crazy shit my direction. So I am excited to be painting again for me. So it's been too long. So.
Lovely. And Kara actually put out an extremely cool coloring book, which I will go get at some point. And that's all I'm gonna say about that.
For now. I have like 50 copies, so I
can. Yeah, maybe you want to
do show and tell too.
Anyway, thanks, Kara.
Yeah,
Amanda and friend, do you want to go next? I'm not familiar with your friend. It's his first time here. Go ahead.
Yeah, it's my partner Micah. So we're gonna be creating something together. We're in Lake in the Hills, and then a word that came to mind when we sat for the minute was cherish. So I guess just like cherish those around me, like the time spent. So,
yeah, for me, the word understanding came up, because for me, to truly understand is all encompassing in the sense of love, connectivity, respect, oneness. So just utter understanding, both of yourself, of the world, of people around you. And yeah, so just genuine understanding.
Thank you.
I almost drank your coffee. Thank you for having me, by the way, too. I appreciate like you allowing me into the space. So thank you.
Of course. Of course. Thanks for coming, Micah.
Yeah.
Brenda, you want to go next?
Yeah, I'm Brenda. I'm in Green Bay, Wisconsin. And grounding was what came to me. And if anybody's interested in self-care, that word resonates with me because I'm writing about it right now. So I'll put in the chat how you can find that writing if you're interested.
Awesome. Yeah, I believe all of you are members of Kindreds. And if you're not, you can feel free to join. It's a private Facebook group. The main thrust of that is to have a safe space for creatives, and it's for all creatives. Visual arts is definitely a part of it, but there are so many different ways to be creative, from cooking to baking to writing to performing to whatever. So also always feel free to invite people who you feel could use that space, because we definitely, throughout our lives, folks have been exiled from creative endeavors unfairly. Because, you know, Becky's the creative one. You're not the creative one. So would encourage you to invite folks to the Kindred space as well. All right, Kate and Sally, you in there, your little square by your together. That's so cool. You guys are next. look like the Bobbsey twins. It's adorable.
it's my house, so I go first.
All right.
I was just thinking about being here now with my dear friend and how much fun this is. I was thinking of, and I haven't made art for years. Really, I haven't done anything.
You've been creative.
I've been creative with writing, but not with visual art. So I'm working on this thing. I don't know if you can see it, but I did a tile like this when I was in ceramic.
Amazing.
And it's, well, I didn't do the flower. The flower was on the piece, but I'm drawing a woman's torso. And I kind of started this idea because I saw the vagina monologue. So it focused me on the vagina in a way. And then it has two breasts, obviously, but there's one with a breast, one without, because some of us don't have breasts. So that's it. And now I'm going to try and paint it.
Right on, Kate.
Thank
and you. Just real quick, Kate just said she hasn't been creative. She just finished a children's book.
Oh.
So whatever, Kate.
She said she hasn't been making art as in visual art, but yeah. She's definitely been creative.
Okay. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. I was just pointing out that, yes, indeed, you have been making art.
Okay, thanks.
Just wanted to validate that. I just love you, Kate. That's all.
She's so lovable. I appreciate that.
And we are in Milwaukee. We're in the Bayview,
right.
The very creative artsy Bayview neighborhood of Milwaukee. And I guess what I was thinking about when you said what is most important really is being with friends, being with people you love. Taking time to be with them because, you know, Ukraine is on my mind. So I'm thinking about people there who are separated from their loved ones, maybe won't ever see them again, who've lost them. And so it makes me appreciate my my people, and I want to hug them all and hold them all close. So I'm starting out with a little yellow bird today, and it's going to get the blue color of the Ukrainian flag on it somewhere. And that's going to be my little meditation. It's a little peace bird for Ukraine. And I'm one of those people who cannot just do one thing at a time. So I've got like four different projects. Kate's got one. I've got like five different projects so that I could work on whatever struck me as what most important today. So that was a great question. Thank you for asking that.
You're welcome. Thanks, guys. Verena, you're next.
Okay. What came up for me was to flow, and connection. And this morning, I like to write little intentions for the day. So I wrote for this morning earlier to see the beauty and harmony in all things. Actually, I wrote, I have an ear and vision for harmony and beauty.
Mm.
So.
Love that. Thank you so much.
I like to put it in present tense to embody it more. You know, statements like that.
Yeah. I just read, so if anybody's from, you're probably all familiar with Julia Cameron's course, The Artist's Way. She just put out a new version of that. It's like, for those of us with shorter attention spans and need to do things quicker, she put out a 6-week version instead of a 12-week version. And that's a chapter that I just finished talking about, doing that present tense rather than this will happen, this is happening. So thank you for that. Wonderful reminder. Thank you. All right, Bree, you get to be the last square in Hollywood Squares.
The last square. Hey, I'm Bree. I'm in Appleton, Wisconsin. And this morning I was going to do a neurographica. And to do that, you have to have something that you're thinking about before you start your flowy, scribbly lines. And I wasn't sure what I was going to do. So I pulled a tarot card and I got the 9 of Pentacles. So then, of course, I was immediately thinking about my chosen family and the choices we're making to like build the life that we want and like kind of, you know, where we're going and what we're doing to get there. So I guess sort of future building. Yeah.
Sweet. All right, you guys. So with that, everybody can just start doing whatever it is that they want to do. Before we got together, I was trying to choose music and I thought like, because of the snow, I thought I'm putting Bob Marley on. I don't care. I want something that reminds me of the tropics. And a good friend of mine just left for Jamaica, and we're having Miss Brown's Jamaican food catered today. So it's all about Bob Marley. So that's going to be our music today.
I was actually the other day, so my thing lately is on YouTube, I look for the binaural beats, and the 432 gigahertz is like really good for meditation. And apparently Bob Marley's music is like right at that 432 megahertz. And I was like, that makes so much sense.
Yeah, that does.
So yeah, it's kind of cool.
That is fascinating. That's my preferred meditation is to music like that. It's the binaural beats. So yeah.
I love it. And a lot of times it's just, you know, sort of the same, I don't know, sort of a loop, you know, of a lot of the same sounds. And so it's kind of cool when it's actually something more unique and a little more linear, which is, I guess, kind of ironic, but I enjoy linear music for something so universal and cyclical, but oh well, you know, I guess it counts if I listen to it over and over again.
Yeah. Oh, you know, I use Insight Timer, and they've got a lot of binaural beats on there in the free version. Yeah, a lot. Nice.
There's one that's like, it's called, and I can't even remember who published it. It's just on YouTube. But it's Saturn's Gate is the name of it. And actually some of the music or some of the sounds that they've integrated are sounds that have been recorded in space. And it's really kind of neat. It's just, you know, kind of metallic sounds and stuff. I think, oh, it's something I don't really think about is like, what does it sound like in space? So, I mean, obviously you get what Hollywood portrays, but it's not the same. Could this be love? Don't let them fool you, or even try to school you.
So I'm inspired to say something to you all. I was just struck by how overwhelmed I am with gratitude for having so many cool creative people in my life. I also wanted to offer, I have this passion project that I do on the side, and it's a podcast. I was a broadcaster for about 11 years. And it was a really important gig for me, and I was really sad when I lost it. And in the last year, I kind of got my voice back again and started this podcast on the side. And I've spent the last, since September till now, putting together episodes that express what creativity has done for me in my healing in my life. And I'm almost finished telling those stories. I'm going to be doing my last episode with that. And it'll be the 8th episode, and it'll be the last episode with my telling my healing stories. And with that, I'll be beginning my second season in May. And that'll be telling your stories. That'll be telling other people's stories and how the arts have helped them heal. Because I know everyone has a story. Most people have more than one story about how the arts have helped them heal. And what I'm asking right now, because I'm moved to do so, is if you have a story, please share it with me, whether it's through email or Facebook Messenger, or whether you know someone who you think has a remarkable healing story through the arts, please reach out to me and share it with me. In this moment, I'm really overwhelmed by, by the whole process and by, by being held by you and just all of it. Love, love, love. So, Katie, your owl, look at your owl. Oh my God. And just, oh my God, it's huge. It's huge. Look at it. Oh, it's gorgeous. It's gorgeous. And Katie's been working so hard to put so much intention into that canvas. I'm so grateful, and I'm so blessed. And please share your heart with me. Because the whole the whole intention of all of it is to get the word out that we're all connected. And I love that you have a spiral on your canvas, Verena. That's just everything. The intention is to get the word out that we're not alone, that the arts help people heal, and that we need it now more than ever. So that's all. I'm going to keep painting now, but I love you guys. And thank you. We're gonna listen to Bob now. We're gonna jam.
My feelings for you are mutual, Stacy. So it's all good.
I love you too, sweetie.
Thank you.
We came together in very funny circumstances. So
Well, and through part of the CFC stuff, I mean, I've shared a lot of my journey, and I haven't shared a lot of my journey. So you're absolutely right. Art is healing, and it's necessary. So that's where today I said I'm called to work in my heart, just to do fun, healing, beautiful things, and not be in the manifestation of beauty, not in the unearthing. Just, I'm on the other side, you know, for now at least. So
I was so moved by your laundry painting. I can't tell you.
That way, the way it all happened, and I don't know, all I can say is meant to be. Meant to be. Yeah.
Thank you. And y'all are so deep with me, I just dig it. Brina, I might need to buy that painting from you.
It's I wrote into it, courage. I step into my courage, fearlessly being me.
Oh my God.
It's got an intention in there.
That's amazing. Yeah, I might need that. You just keep going. I'll keep going with mine.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
That's awesome.
It's remarkable that it's a spiral and we didn't even talk about that.
Stacy, did you say the name of your podcast?
No, I did not. The name of my podcast is Full Spirals.
And it's good.
Yeah.
I listen. I enjoy it.
Thank you.
Wow.
As
no,
do I,
no,
I very
understand.
Much enjoy it.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really good, Stacy. I love it.
I was afraid when you were saying it was your last one that you were saying you weren't going to be doing anymore, and I was going to beg you to please continue.
Yeah, I'm gonna keep doing it. I'm
The focus
for the most on. Part finished with my stories. I'm ready to tell other people's stories. Feels like it's time.
Stacy, I would love to chat with you, Stacy, on your podcast, because I'm a bipolar artist.
Mm.
And our stories are often told by others, but not by us.
Love that.
So I would love the opportunity to talk about that and how not all of us are scary monsters that we see on TV.
Uh-huh.
Some of us live normal lives and with challenges, but we do live and we don't commit crimes. And that's most of us.
Yeah, thank you. Can you put your... Well, we can get, we're friends on Facebook, right?
Yeah, I think so, or we'll do it.
Well, and I can connect you guys.
Sally yeah. will connect us, so.
Otherwise, I was going to say you can put your email in the chat.
Oh, okay.
You can DM her through.
Yeah.
Kindred.
Yeah, that would be great. I would love that opportunity because I have a book launch coming up in June. So I'd love for people to know about it. And, that's going to be June 5th in Menominee Falls.
Oh, and that's right. We had this conversation because I grew up in Menominee Falls.
Right. And so, and then I'm hoping maybe, I shouldn't say anything about it, but maybe having an East Coast launch if I can get into Family Week in Provincetown, Massachusetts. They have a Family Week for LGBTQIA+. People and books are very inclusive and open and everything. So I'm hoping. Good to have hope.
Well, anybody who wants to put their information, Kara, you too.
You know mine. I'm happy to. I'd love to do that. That would be a really cool project to work on together. And you got my digits, girl.
Mm-hmm. And I was thinking too. You could put the information about your the clothing line and all of that. You can put that in the chat here.
Yeah.
If folks wanna support art. Yay, supporting art. Your clothing is gorgeous.
I'd love to see your clothing line. So
yeah. So full disclosure, I didn't actually design the clothes, but my art is on the clothing. There's a place in Montreal that takes artists' work, and they print on demand. So when you order it, they make it and they hand make it there in a studio in Montreal. So it's not like sweatshop labor. And it's pretty cool because they've got graphic designers that kind of work with you and kind of help decide where to put everything on their products. And it's really cool. It's just kind of a fun little adventure. But yeah, I'll put my links in there for.
That's neat. Very neat.
In fact, I'll just do my website because that's easier. And then there's links to all of it on my website, on my portfolio site.
Is your coloring book on there too?
It is. There's even a tab that says coloring books. So, and I can make you custom coloring books too. So.
Instead of the blue, I should mute there.
Everybody can also always feel free to do that on the Kindreds page. Kindreds page is all about supporting local art and not local art, art period. Right on.
Wondering if the little bunny will hop across my patio. I've had the last few days while I've been out here having coffee, the tiniest little, most adorable baby bunny has hopped across almost to my feet, and then it realizes I'm there, and then it scurries away because it's terrified. It's like, oh my gosh, a human. But it's like so adorable.
I just showed that picture to Jeff this morning.
Totally. Tiny little ears.
Oh my God, so cute.
That would be very cool if it shows up, Kara. Try to show us.
Yeah. Itty bitty. It's like, you know, the size of like, I don't know, smaller than a pear or an apple. Little bitty guy, girl, gal, it. Bunny. So cute.
I wonder if it's a jackrabbit.
I think it's a cottontail. They're really? All over the place around here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I assume they're, I don't know. I haven't looked at the actual name of them out here, but they have jackrabbits supposedly, but I have not seen any. I just see your standard cottontails. I think it's like a lot of places they've kind of taken over the jackrabbit population.
Oh,
or
yeah.
Interbred. I know that was true in like Kansas and Oklahoma. They kind of interbred and the jackrabbits kind of disappeared. So I don't know if that's true for out here too. We're pretty suburban though, so there's a lot of the little cottontail bunnies everywhere, and there are a lot of coyotes hence also, and hawks.
Thank you.
Anybody else ever have that one paint tube that no matter what you do, every time you try to open it, you have to go get pliers?
Oh yeah.
It seems to be my manganese blue, always.
I commit the sin that Bree's mom would kill me for. I use my teeth
Oh,
oh God, that's me.
Listen, teeth are jewels, not tools.
Teeth are jewels, not tools.
You really only get the one set, so treat them nice.
That's the truth.
I actually don't do it as much as I used to because of that, because you said, because I can just
see, you hear me in your head like, being like, no, teeth are jewels, not tools. Don't do it.
This is the one time they're going to crack off when I do it.
Oh, be cringe.
All right, and I just almost dipped my brush in my coffee cup, so I'm moving that.
Ooh. Yeah, I put my coffee back behind on the left, water cup in the front on the right.
Definitely an occupational hazard.
Since I don't have someone next to me, you know, 6 inches away, I don't have to worry about them.
I just became inspired to, gonna have to host like an outdoor Kindreds Create Along in person someday. Wouldn't it be cool to do it outside and just all create in one space?
So where are you located at?
What's that?
Where are you located at?
I'm in Wisconsin.
Oh, you're far away from me.
Yeah, so we would have to pick like a central, I'm feeling like really going for it, like national park or something.
New Mexico?
Wouldn't that be great? Mexico?
We could all go to Ghost Ranch and pretend we're walking in, just walk in Georgia O'Keeffe's footsteps.
Okay.
New Mexico. Abiquiu. Or Taos, you know. Okay. The quintessential artist destination.
Mm-hmm. I was just inspired to burn some cedar. I don't know why, but I'm going with it. It smells lovely.
I do that there, everyone will freak out and start calling the fire department. Here, be like, I smell fire. Neighborhood Facebook page is going to light up. You smell that? Is that someone's chimenea? No.
So sage would really be a problem.
Yeah. You know, actually the sage, probably people wouldn't notice it as much. It smells enough like weed around here. No.
Oh, that's right. Weed isn't a big deal by you.
Mm-mm.
Everybody's got that going on.
Although, there is plenty of white sage just in the brush that burns, but I don't know. I think people worry more when they smell the wood fire because they're like, that's someone's house or it's the national forest right there.
Let's see, you're with the white sage, you are from Southern California.
I'm in Riverside County, but we're kind of like Northwest Riverside County. So we're like, I've got the Santa Ana Mountains here and just like over the mountain is Orange County. And then, you know, to the south, I don't know, like 40 miles of San Diego County and kind of right near a lot of different spots. So sprawling suburbia, but it's more deserty than beachy where we're at because we're on the dry side of the Santa Anas.
Oh yeah. Yeah, I remember still white sage growing out in your area.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's beautiful. It's cool. I like to go over. I don't do it very often, but we've got some SoCal Edison has some of those high tension power lines that kind of run through and break up our subdivisions. And there's a cool little trail you can hike down. And there's tons of it down there. And they don't care if you pick the sage down there. So it's kind of fun to pick sage and you can make your own little bundles and stuff with it.
Right. Because I grow it in my garden.
Yeah, but, I bet there's a lot of stuff that grows up there that you can't do right where we're at just because you have so much more moisture on average anyway.
Well, it gets really dry where I'm at. Like, I'm 30 miles east of Reading. So,
So it's deserty there too.
Yeah, it's like high desert here, but it's beautiful right now. I mean, it's always beautiful, but it's real pretty.
Cool.
Yeah.
I'm waiting for the pelicans to come back here.
Ooh.
On the river, yeah. Seems late this year. It's usually mid-March.
I was gonna say, I was thinking they're supposed to be in Nebraska and Kansas right around now, too. So that's probably on their pathway to get up there.
Wow.
Wherever they're coming from.
I mean, I guess they have their own schedule, but I'm like,
they're like, it's kind of warm down here. I think we'll stay a little longer.
Right.
I don't know. I guess if the eating is good, then, you know, maybe if it didn't get as cold, there's probably more for them to enjoy extended winter break.
Down low, right now, and the
I'm in a phase right now where I'm kind of rediscovering my style because it's been so long since I've put the brush to canvas for my, you know, my own ideas. I've also found that after 10 years of working for Pino's Palette, I'm kind of like, is this my style? Is this someone else's style? I occasionally will go back to some of my really old works and I'm like looking and I'm like comparing brush strokes. I'm like, okay, it's still mine, still mine.
Cool.
I think there were enough of the early, you know, kind of paintings, albeit not so great, but the earlier ones were mine, that sometimes I confuse, you know, like it's hard to tell. The style has evolved greatly, which is a good thing, because I think that's kind of the beauty with it, is so many different artists and kind of leaving their mark. You get this kind of delightful hybrid of hundreds of artists. So obviously the public likes it.
what is it that you've been doing that you
So Pino's Palette, it is a paint instant studio or company. It's actually a franchise. So each one is individually owned and operated, and they've got local artists staffing each one, but it's paint and sip. So the guests sign up and then they show up and they drink wine or beer or whatever is on offer, or it may be BYOB. And then a professional artist leads everybody through step by step so that everybody goes home with a painting. And it's usually pretty much the same painting, but sometimes you have some more creative folks that get in there and change it up. It's like art for non-artists.
Okay.
Or for just people who just want to have fun and do some crafting. It's a pretty fun gig most of the time. I haven't been in the studio doing it in a long time. I do a lot of virtual classes now just because my health and everything and of course our studio's out here shut down for quite a while too with a pandemic, but they're open and operating. I just haven't been brave enough to go back. So
do you teach virtually for Scott and Cherie?
Yeah
That's cool.
Yeah,
that never took off for us,
really.
Nope.
We do a lot of corporate parties, and I think just, you know, out here culturally, we've got a lot of med tech in Irvine, which is right by Tustin. And so we've got a lot of people who are very, very conscientious about staying safe and healthy, and a lot of people working from home and stuff. So
Yeah, that's so much conscientious here in this country.
Works out. I kind of gathered that a little bit.
Not so much giving a crap about anybody's health.
It's not really that way out where I live either. I mean, it's like 40 miles difference, and it's like being in Texas. So it's kind of funny. It's interesting. Yeah. I mean, it's as far as the mask wearing, there's a lot of things that are not like Texas right here, but there are a lot of things that are strikingly similar, which, you know, moving out here, there were a lot of stereotypes of mine that were broken. I was like, what? California is not just all beaches and liberals?
Wow. Okay.
It never even clicked with me. I was like, oh yeah, Ronald Reagan's from California. Oh, I guess I should.
Oh my God, and Schwarzenegger.
Yeah.
I liked him.
Well, he's not from California, but he was a big deal for a while.
He's had some funny things to say about the last administration. I wasn't here to vote for him, so I don't really have much of an opinion on him. I didn't have, you know, I wasn't living under his reign, so to speak.
I've been thinking about doing the paint and sip. I just haven't found an inn yet.
Oh.
That'd be a lot of fun.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun. Trying to think what we I think probably, and it's not really even close to you, would be Sacramento. We might still have one in Elk Grove.
Yeah, I heard that. I mean, I think in Redding, yeah, which is 35 miles away, there's one. Yeah. So what do? You just get in touch with a place that does that, and then you can be the featured artist, or
for our brand, yeah, it's like you just apply at the studio with the you apply like you would any other job. And it's just a part-time job. Yeah. Part-time gig.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I don't know, you know, as far as how other brands or other, there's a lot of mom and pops that are doing that sort of thing. And
right.
I'm sure it varies. I'm sure there's a certain similarity among all of them. I think a lot of them kind of use the same general template, licensed or not.
Right.
But it's fun. It's a fun concept.
Right. Well, I don't really drink, but I know a lot of people do.
they like to. Well, like, you don't have to drink.
Yeah. I've done workshops. You know, I held workshops, you know, locally here where it was like a lot of inner work, right? And somehow I don't know if alcohol would mix with that very well, but people around here, you know, they're really looking for a way to just get away from home and all that.
Mm-hmm. It's definitely a way to do that.
Yeah, do something different.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm actually in recovery, Verena. And I've been working there for 6 years, and my Kara actually was the trainer when I got the job. And I remember asking her, because I just assumed that people were going to get freaking loaded because I'm a recovering alcoholic. And I remember asking, like, what do you do if somebody throws up in the bathroom? And she was just kind of like, people don't do that. They're too busy painting. Okay.
All right. Well, yeah.
I had it happen once in the 4.5 years I was in Dallas, one time.
Yeah.
I had that happen.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then I'm sure it's happened. It happened once when I was at Tustin too, but really, you know, twice over 10 years.
And I've only had one icky situation with a guy that, but he did pregame, right? Like when he showed up, he was mm-hmm. drunk.
And those are the people that do that there, or, and they haven't eaten, you know, they show up and they're like, you guys have any food? No.
Yeah.
We do now, but we didn't then. Like, we've got some chips.
Right. We've got
a bag of chips is not enough. Yeah, exactly.
Which are amazing, but.
Yeah, what people do, like amongst some of my friends, what we do is like we have tea parties where everybody brings some tea.
Oh,
nice. That'd be fun.
Yeah, so it's a little
bit. If you way more into that.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
Yeah.
Well, and out here now they've got the paint and puff thing. So they've got the studios here.
I was wondering about that.
Yeah, I don't know if they're BYO or if there's like, if they work with a dispensary and then you like, you know, you pick from their menu what you want. It's kind of funny. I've never been to one. Goodness. I can imagine it would be interesting though.
Let's see, the Pain and Puff down in Southern California, is that?
Yeah, there's one in, there's one out of Ontario or Rancho Cucamonga, which is just like, I don't know, it's like 30 miles north of here. But I think they travel, they'll go to LA and because of where they're at, they can do, or they go up in the desert cities and stuff. Yeah, it's pretty funny. I've only seen, you know, the pictures on their website. It's actually one of the ones is run by somebody who used to work at Tustin years ago. She was one of their original artists that they hired, and then she got fired. I don't remember what she was. I think she was stealing. which is pretty funny. So I'm not highly motivated to, you know, reach out to her business. I think she initially stole some of our paintings too, which is,
oh man.
Wow.
This is, she's fulfilling all the negative stereotypes.
So. Right.
Like, you're the reason people don't want it legal.
Right.
So I'm going to tell on myself. When I was first setting up, I was like, man, I can't find certain colors. And it's like, these brushes, although these are definitely my brushes, my longtime brushes, none of them feel familiar to me. And then I was like, where's my such and such? And I thought, oh, my toolbox. And I went in and I found all the favorites I had tucked away. And this is how cluttered my studio is. I have.
Oh.
I was like, oh, there you are, friends. I had tucked them away to go somewhere and paint remotely. I don't know where at this point, but. Same but different topic. This art market that I'm getting ready for is through the Riverside Museum of Art, and it's helping fund the new Cheech Marine Museum of Chicano Art.
Oh.
And it's all of Cheech's like personal collection. He's wow. like a huge art collector. And so I'm really hoping like he'll Cheech show up at the Chong? Festival. Uh-huh, yeah. That's the one.
Cool.
Yeah.
Hmm.
So I'm like, maybe he'll show up to the festival. Maybe he'll stop by my booth and we'll get to meet him.
Hmm.
That would be pretty cool.
It would be pretty cool. He's pretty cool. But yeah, it's really neat because it's like the biggest museum of its type. And it's, you know, it's starting out with just his collection, and then they'll have you know, traveling exhibits and stuff of Chicano artists. And
oh man, how cool is cool. that?
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. And I really love is that they decided to do it in Riverside instead of in LA, because LA has a lot of museums, but they're actually kind of keeping it where there's a larger Chicano population who can actually enjoy the art without having to go to LA and some of the more kind of elitist type art
mm-hmm.
communities. So
mm-hmm.
definitely making me wish I'd have taken Spanish in high school instead of German. It's not. And I've actually looked at the community colleges here. I was like, community college, I could go back, do that.
There's an app called Duolingo, which is surprisingly helpful.
Yeah, it's really good.
Is it? I'll check it out.
I've learned good. Quite a bit off of it.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
Yeah, I got that one. It's cool.
Because I feel like that would be useful if I want to be a docent there or love to teach in an art museum, but I don't have my master's degree and most of them require that at this point. The education and the art history, but
so the undergrad degree is in art?
Yeah, art education, visual art education. So yeah, so it was a combination education and fine arts degree.
You could maybe be able to do methods teaching though in the college.
Oh, yeah?
My husband doesn't have a doctorate. He has 2 master's degrees and he's presently ad hoc at a local college here in Green Bay for the student teachers. So he's teaching methods and, you know, you might be able to get something like that where you're interacting with the future art teachers.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
Do you want to see if Chris can go with you there?
I'm sure they can.
Yeah. Or they'll help.
Just a heads up, friends, we are about 10 minutes out from the end. No big deal. Just wanted to let you know. I have to go to the bathroom.
Good time.
Not that you needed to know that.
You have permission.
The update.
You have permission to go.
I have permission to use the bathroom. Awesome.
Yep.
Thank you. Dude, are you packing up to leave?
Has anybody else been having vivid dreams lately?
Some, yeah.
Yes. But then I don't remember them. I wake up, but they're vivid while they're happening.
Yeah. I'll remember, you know, little random bits here and there. And I'm like, I don't remember the rest of the story.
They're very important.
Yeah, definitely.
In the dream state.
And there's a lot of universal shift happening right now too, so makes sense.
Thank you.
Really funny. A little lizard came up, and I don't know if I can catch him before he runs away. But... he's like, oh, there he went.
Oh, yeah.
Aw.
He's like, what is that lady doing?
So people in that are here now, do you post in the group?
Generally after the Create Alongs folks post what they made, yes. And actually we are at 11:30, everybody.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow.
Kind of crazy.
Time flies, man.
Is everybody okay with me taking a group picture?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, of which I worked on two things.
Oh, yeah, you did.
With our things?
Yeah.
With our art or without?
Sure, with your art. I can't do mine.
Glasses off.
Mine's taped to the, well, I could probably take it off.
I'm trying to get the right angle here.
Take me just
not have a weird shadow on it. Yeah, that'll work.
Cool. Oh, cool. All right. I love seeing all the art.
Da-da-da.
Oh, and the owl, and oh, that's so cool.
All right, are we ready?
I think so.
One.
There's two pictures not seen.
Can you pick yours up or not? If you can't pick yours up, that's okay. You can just be gorgeous in the photo. Okay, ready? One. Two, three.
Did it work?
Or
I think Stacy, I think our Bayview friends noticed that we took the picture. They had the sound off, and so now they noticed what we're doing.
Oh. Okay, again or what?
Again?
Yeah, I think we should do it again so that the Bayview people can give their artwork too.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Oh,
lovely.
All the artwork. Okay. I don't want my piece.
Stacy, we can't hear you.
Thank you, Brenda. I said so many cool, important things.
I'm sure you did.
Not really. One, two, three. Yay! You guys are awesome.
Well, this was a lot of fun. Thank you.
Yes, thank you very much.
Thanks for holding space.
I wouldn't have spent painting this morning.
Enjoy your housewarming.
You can totally make a
space. Yeah. Have a fun party.
Thank you all so much for coming. Post your art on the Kindreds page if you have a second. And please, again, reach out to me. If you have a story.
Yay.
All right.
Love. Have a wonderful, wonderful day.
Thank you.
Bye, guys.
Nice to meet everybody.
Bye, everybody.
Take care. Bye. Love you.